Hey guys, what's up? Connor here. It's about 6:15 in the morning and I'm taking Bella on a walk. I think you guys know where this is at or where I'm at. If you haven't checked out the Boise State video up here, but just to clarify, this is kind of like my safe space. I've been going here for the past 4 to 5 years. And it's amazing what the river and the scenery can do. You know, whether I was stressed out about school or stressed out about things in my home life or just kind of confused in general, I would come here and kind of clear my head a little bit, think a little bit about what's going on, do a little reflection. And it was amazing. But sadly, this video isn't about that. This video is a goodbye. Right now is my last time I'll be walking Bella until I come back from college on my first break. I'm gonna cherish that real quick and I'll see you guys in a couple minutes. Like I said earlier, this video is a goodbye. A goodbye to the amazing people in my life who have raised me and helped me become the person I am today. And mostly a goodbye to the town that I grew up in for 13 years of my life. Went through all of schooling with all of these people and lived in different houses, but the mentality stayed the same of just how thankful I am that I was raised in such an amazing community like Orting. Yeah, we're gonna go around town and film a couple different places and I'll have a couple different things to say. So I hope you guys enjoy that. And if you do, make sure you like and subscribe. Your guys' support is amazing and so much of it fills my heart, and I'm so appreciative of it. So thank you so much. And let me know down below what your thoughts were on this video. So see you guys in a couple minutes. This is my high school, or was my high school, I guess. Where do I even start? I think I'll thank all my friends for being my friends. I have an amazing support system. And so many people just talked with me and became friends with me and hung out with me when I really needed it. And I'm so appreciative of that. I think the next people, I think the most important people to thank while I'm here are definitely the teachers and the staff. I had a lot of times, especially towards sophomore year, where I was a little confused. I was lost in a lot of things. I didn't quite understand a ton of things about life and why things were turning out the way they were. And I had amazing teachers who helped not only just educate me, but just shape me into who I am today. A lot of amazing teachers who I still have talks with, who I still go to lunch with, who I still have vivid memories of constantly just offering their support. And I am so appreciative of all of that. And I think this place gets a pretty bad rap sometimes. And I think part of it is because students want the teachers to do all the work for them. But I think really what needs to happen there is the teachers are gonna help you if you're just being honest and being kind with them. They're great people and great human beings, and they care a lot about your success. I think this goes for any school, but you've gotta be willing to reciprocate that. I care about my teachers a ton. I still do. And I think that they can sense that pretty well. So, yeah, I think I'm really thankful for all the amazing opportunities I had here, all the great memories I shared with my friends, and not even my friends, but just peers and the staff. And I was really thankful this year, my senior year, to have my little sister be a freshman and my little brother be a sophomore. And that was awesome to experience being at the same place as them and making sure that I could take care of them and watch over them. And I'm really thankful for all that. But I think Ording High School is where I grew the most as a person. I think that I was definitely a much rougher product freshman and sophomore year. And I think that the people around me and the experiences I went through and the hard times and the great times culminated to me being a person I'm very proud of being today. And I think that I just attribute all of that to the people I hung out with and the people I saw every day, my teachers, you know, from the lunch ladies to the secretaries at the front of the school to, you know, my individual teachers that I'd see on a daily basis. I am so thankful for all of that, and so thankful for just getting to know them on a way that not a lot of students get to. And I don't know why that happens, and I don't know how that happens, but I'm super appreciative of that. So, yeah. Goodbye, Ording High School.
When life leaves you high and dry, I'll be at your door tonight. If you need help, if you need help, I'll shut down the city lights. I'll lie, cheat, I'll beg and bribe to make you well, to make you well. When enemies are at your door, I'll carry you away from war. If you need help, if you need help.
Our next stop on this strange journey is the stadium that all of our games are played on. This place has a lot of amazing memories for me as well, mostly athletic ones. So we're gonna take a quick walk around the track and just kind of think about it. I went to middle school right over there, and it was fun, but I didn't really know what I was getting myself into when I got to high school. And I didn't know if I was going to play high school sports or, well, I knew I was going to play lacrosse. I didn't know if I was going to play football. And freshman year, I tried out for football. And I don't know how this happened, and it probably shouldn't have happened, but I was the only freshman that got to suit up for varsity games, and that meant a lot to me. I don't think I deserved it necessarily, but I think that I'm just really grateful for the opportunities that I received from it. And then, of course, there's lacrosse. My 3 years playing here means a ton to me. And just being able to say that I played with the Ording name on my chest is a huge deal. For all my life, I had to go play at other places. Ording didn't have a program. In the freshman year of high school, I went and played at Bethel High School. And finally, sophomore year, we changed that, and I got to play with the Ording logo on the front of my chest. And this year, we went to the semifinals for state. And that is huge. Football-wise, we weren't extremely successful, but the lessons learned on this field are some that I'll never forget. Lessons like, do everything with full force. You know, don't hold anything back. Sometimes you gotta work harder than the people next to you to just be the same as them, right? There are a lot of gifted people, a lot of talented people in this world. And sometimes you gotta outwork them, and that's the fun part of it. But I think my favorite memory from this stadium is actually where I'm about to be standing. Right here. Where I'm standing right now is the last place that my dad coached me in lacrosse. It's my freshman year. Bethel had a game down here because we wanted to see if we could schedule one to get interest from lacrosse. He had been diagnosed with colon cancer and had been battling it for 9 months already. And I don't know how or why, but he decided to continue to coach while he was going through chemo. And he said that this was his medicine. And I look up to that a lot. And so where I'm standing right now, he coached me as when I was a freshman. And I don't remember if we won or lost. I don't think that really matters, but the fact that it could have been anywhere. We could have been away, we could have been at Bethel, but the fact that the last game that he ever coached me at was Ording High School Stadium, the end of my freshman year, is a really big deal to me. And if you watch closely before every lacrosse game and every football game in my high school career, I'd just come here and kneel down and kind of talk to him a little bit. And I'm super appreciative of everything that he's done for me. And it's just kind of crazy to think that we've come all this way. And so, yeah, let's keep walking. Kind of going back on the same vibe as the teachers, but the amount of amazing coaches that I've had, I'm truly blessed and thankful for. Football coaches, we had a lot of turmoil over the past 2 years of coaching, and for some that might have been kind of destructive to the culture of the team and might have caused a lot of hardships. But I think that the people that we brought in and the people who are continuing to be here are amazing coaches, and they have done a fantastic job of not only teaching people how to play the game of football, but how to be a person, how to be, I guess, for lack of, you know, better words, how to be a man and how to grow up and realize that there are going to be situations that aren't going to favor you, but you've got to go and do everything you can to change that regardless. And that's something that I'm extremely thankful for. That's something that I know a lot of my friends have learned a lot of lessons on this field, and I have indeed. And I think that that all comes back to the coaching that we were blessed to receive. And yeah, that's the stadium, I guess.
Your hope dangling by a string, I'll share in your suffering to make you well, to make you well. Give me reasons to believe that you would do the same for me, and I would do it for you.
All right, and one of the last spots on our little journey through town here is actually coming up on my right here in a couple minutes. I moved to Ording at the age of 5 from Everett, Washington, so about 2 hours south. And it never felt weird for me because I was, you know, about to go into kindergarten. And of course I didn't know anyone, but hardly anyone else knew anyone either, so. I was homeschooled in the 3rd and 5th grade, which was a little odd for me, just cause I bounced between knowing people constantly to not seeing anyone ever really. But it's weird to think that you grow up so fast. I remember looking at the high schoolers and thinking, wow, those kids are really cool and really got it all together. I'm in the 2nd grade. I don't know how to multiply yet. But it's crazy how fast life moves and how it all changes. And so for the final location on my, well, not the final, one of the final locations on my goodbye to Ording is the welcome to Ording sign, actually. I won't be reading that anytime soon, which is kind of sad, but Here it is. It says, welcome to Ording, small town, big view, and then our population and everything, when we're incorporated and all that. And I know it doesn't have a big view right now, but generally speaking, when it's not classic Washington, right about there is Mount Rainier and his beautiful view. And I remember fond memories of driving into town and seeing a beautiful sunset with Mount Rainier. And I'm gonna miss those a lot. So, on to the next place. Hey guys, the last little stop before I head out is home. This has been my house for the past, I think, 6 or 7 years. I didn't grow up in it. I grew up in a house actually probably like half a mile away from here, but I went to high school in this house and went through all the bad times and the good times in this house, and I'm super thankful for all the amazing opportunities that my family provided for me. Roof over my head and the food and just the great memories and the great times, and I appreciate them all so much. And it's been rough. I just had to go say goodbye to all of my close friends, and that hurt a lot. But I know that while my time in Ording for now is up a little bit, I'll definitely be back. I'll be back in Thanksgiving. I'll be back for winter break. I'll be back for spring break. I'll be back in the summer. I might be gone from Ording for a little bit, but I'll be back. So thank you guys so much for watching this video. I appreciate the support a ton, and just know that from now on it's going to be college content, and hopefully that is what you're interested in and other people are interested in. So make sure you again like this video, subscribe to the channel for more videos, and see you guys soon. As always, live, love, and learn today.